I want to talk a little bit about Alibaba and the model itself, because I think for many in the West, if you will, they don't necessarily understand it. And to the extent that the extent that I could try to compare it to Amazon, which I know you think is an unfair comparison, one of the things that's so fascinating to me is that Amazon and Jeff Bezos have pursued what might be described as a very asset-heavy business model. They're buying airplanes. They want to own the entire supply chain from beginning to end. And Alibaba has effectively an asset-light business. It is very much, in terms of the retail piece of this, the opposite. You don't want to own the warehouses. You don't want to own the logistics companies. How do you think about that? Is Jeff Bezos right, or are you right? And is there going to be a meeting in the middle?
I hope both are right. And because the world can never have one model. If the world has only one correct model, the world is too boring, right? We need to have all kinds of models. And the people who do the model should believe in the model. And I believe what I do, right? The difference between Amazon and us, Amazon is more like an empire. Everything they should control themselves, buy and sell. And our philosophy is that we want to be an ecosystem. Our philosophy is to empower others to sell, empower others to service, empower making sure the other people are more powerful than us, making sure with our technology, our innovation, our partners, our 10 million small business sellers, they can compete with Microsoft, IBM. Our philosophy is that we think using internet technology, we can make every company become Amazon. Remember one thing. Today, for our sales, our GMV last year is more than $550 billion. To hire people deliver for us, we need 5 million people. So how can we hire 5 million people deliver things for us to deliver the things we sold? The only way we do is empower the service company, logistics companies, making sure they are efficient, making sure that they make the money, and making sure that they can hire more people.
But without owning the whole chain, can you do it as effectively? The idea that you're watching Amazon being able to deliver things now within hours, literally.
We made 125 cities deliver within one day last year. Imagine, 10 years ago, deliver one thing from Beijing to Hangzhou takes about 8 days. Now you can deliver things from Beijing to Inner Mongolia, some city, within 12 hours. It's improving. You can never expect these things happen within 24 hours. We have patience. So I think, can you imagine that within the 11/11 Singles Day, we sold $17 billion. And by delivering more than 600 million packages within 3 days. This is happening. And this is what we feel proud of. It's not how much money we make. It's not how powerful we are. We think because of the technology, we can make the technology very inclusive, that every small companies can use it. This is my dream. Because I started my first business in 1992 in China. As a small business, in order to borrow money, $5,000 from bank, took me 3 months to acquire, still fail. So difficult to be a small business. Today, with the technology, we can empower them. This is something I want to do.